Alright guys, I'm going to show y'all something here in a minute. This right here is a garden / food plot. What I'm fixing to show you looks like a mess. And I'm going to transform this thing into a food plot like I always do every year. I'm going to show you what it produces, which I didn't think it would. But I was surprised. This is my property. And there's some woods in behind here. It holds some deer I didn't think was in there till a few years ago. But this right here is what this thing looks like now after all this rain we've had in the last several months. It's a mess. We've had so much rain, but I'm going to transform this thing into another food plot. Like I said, I'm going to show you what it can do on just private property. I only have right at 2 acres, and then there's 25 acres of woods in behind me across the creek. I own some land behind the creek, just a little bit, but this is what it looks like. The next few weeks, I get all this garden trash up. I'll get it cleaned up, and we'll see what it looks like. Well, in 2018, in a homemade food plot in the backyard, this is what it produced. Don't be surprised in your backyard. All right, guys, food plot I showed you just a little bit ago. It's the same one, food plot / garden. But I'm going to show you some stuff. I showed you a picture of that deer. I told you I was going to show you what this thing produces. Them deer come right out of here. This is old vines and stuff I throwed in here, but this is a trail coming out of this thick stuff. And every year, or every other year, I try to trim this back, but I've let it grow up thicker because they seem like they like this heavy cover a lot better than it be trimmed back. They got a hiding spot to jump in as soon as they feel threatened. Here's another trail where they come through. The only thing about leaving it this thick is when you shoot them from this plot right here, and I'm hunting under that tree, that's where I put my blind. And I got a feeder right there. But the only thing about when you shoot them in this plot, they hit this thicket and you have no idea which way they're running, so you've got to make a good shot so you'll have a good blood trail. So if you don't, you'll be like my son, and he's done lost too in this hunting area right here. And like I say, it's my land's only 2.5 acres just right here, but there's 25 acres back here across this creek. And they sometimes come across this little knoll here. But down in here is where these deer stay. All up in here. Back over here is the creek. And they've come from several directions in this area right here. And this, where I live, is it's in North Carolina, and I live, I guess you'd say, in a semi-rural area. I'm in the town limits. I don't hunt this a whole lot. My son hunts it more than I do, but I'm not seeing any trash. We've had so much rain in the last 2 months, I'd say. It's just, I couldn't do anything with the garden much. It produced, but it was just hard to do anything with it, and I've let it go now since most of it's, we've got everything out of it. So like I said, I'm going to clean this thing up and get her back into a food plot. I'm not sure what I'm going to plant. I've planted oats in here, and I've planted soybeans before. Seems like it's helped from time to time, switching it back and forth. And I do put corn out, but like I say, this is going to be a little bit of a work detail to get this thing cleaned up like I want it and get this thing planted out and get it ready. So y'all bear with us and we'll see what happens in the next few weeks right before season comes in. We'll bow hunt it some and may muzzle load it. That's about all we'll do. It's not real safe with the rifle, but mostly bow hunt it. But like I say, right up here is where I hunt, under that tree, or my son does. And that's where I killed that nice eight, and he come out right in here. So don't think that just because you've got a small plot that deer won't come in it. If you see deer tracks around your garden or edge of your yard and you got wood plots or wood lots close by, there's potentially good deer in here or on your property. I didn't know there was that many in here. I had 7 bucks come in that year when I killed that 8-point. And I was very surprised. I ain't seen many on a camera. Son's put a camera out across the creek a few weeks ago and had a 4-point and maybe a 6-point. But that year of 2018, I had 2 7s, a 6, an 8, and I think a 4-point. I had several bucks, nice ones. And I think I got one of the best ones that was in here. And I've seen bigger ones after season on the camera. We ain't put up a camera out here yet, but usually put one right in the corner of the property, shining on the food plot, checking it out for us and letting us know what's coming in. Like I say, try it out at your hometown and you'll probably be surprised. I want to wrap this up here in just a few minutes, try to get this short. Got 2 young men here. They're going to be deer hunters, they tell me. So they're going to tell me about deer hunting a little bit and who they're going to hunt with. And then we'll give a little bit more information about what we're doing here at the house. But here's my little grandson, Aiden. And they got a skull mount that Aiden and his dad done the first one ever done. They took it and buried it in the dirt. It's been there for almost a year, probably. That's a little spike I shot. It was last year, first of last year. I thought it was a doe. It had the ears above the horns. I couldn't see the horns. It's a pretty good shot. But anyway, I made a mistake. I didn't want to shoot a spike, but I did. And Aiden decided he wanted a skull mount to see if they could do it. So that's don't look too bad, does it?
Nope.
Looks pretty good?
Yeah.
Well, Aiden, you plan on deer hunting some, don't you?
Yeah.
Gonna hunt with your daddy?
Mm-hmm.
Are you? I think Elijah, he's hunted some over here, ain't you? Over here in the blind?
Yeah.
You didn't see anything, though, did you?
No.
No, not yet. They don't come out all the time, do they?
Nope.
Nope.
It's like they know when we're going to come.
They know when you're out here?
Yeah, it's like that.
Yeah, sometimes. We got a little short video of you turkey hunting, too, don't we? Using that turkey call? Yeah. We'll try to get that load up. It's a little short. Look like he's half asleep, but you're just working it pretty good. But anyway, these boys right here, they want to grow up and kill a deer, and they're not too young right now. They are right at the age to be learning. Y'all ready to go in and get you a shire? You look like you've been running around and got too hot.
Nope.
Yeah, I believe it's time to go in. It's awful hot here. But you tell these folks bye, and I'll give them some more information, but...
Bye.
All right. You going to tell them bye, too?
Bye.
Bye. All right. Them's 2 good boys there. we'll see how they do when they start hunting again this year. And we'll see. But anyway, just a little bit more information on what we're doing down here on the land. A lot of it's going to be patience on how you hunt your property and make a little small food plot. That's what it is. It's all about patience. But we'll see how it goes down here. And we'll try our best to get some of this content out here and let you see how we get the food plot started and how we get it cleaned up and how it progresses and see what kind of deer action we have. Anything shows up, hopefully do. Only thing here is it's changed here in the last years. Got some neighbors moved in on the property next to us, and I'm not sure what that's going to do with the deer movement. He told my son he hunts too, and he's got 11 acres on that side, so he's got a little bit more property than I have to be hunting, and he said he's seen some bucks here lately, so we'll see what happens. But y'all stay tuned. This channel's going to grow. I'm not no professional hunter, just average hunter, just like everybody else is. Going to try my best to give you some information that's helped me out here and on the hunting club that we're on. We got some private land we hunt on over on the and some more property. It's about 500 acres, I think it is. There's about 10 of us on that, and we sort of locked in where we hunt over there. We don't move around a whole lot once we get your spot. You know, it's just hang in right there and hunt that spot. I've hunted that's my spot for the last 3 years, and I think I've killed, I know, at least 3 good bucks. And I may have been in there longer than that. I'm not sure. But anyway, we'll get all that on video, and we got to start going over there and start getting it ready. We're getting a little bit behind. This weather, rain, everything's messed us up. But anyway, I'm Jonathan Herman, and this is my channel. And got a saying we always say, you know, you live it, you love it, and it's in your blood. And it's in my blood. Been hunting all my life, just about since I could hold a gun and hold a bow. And been fishing, was raised doing all that, and try to teach to my sons, both of them. You'll meet my younger son and my oldest son later on in these videos. We get on starting to hunting and fishing some, but I'll try to teach them what I was taught with my uncles. And they taught me, you know, all I know about hunting. And I've learned off of videos and off of YouTube and off of other people that I hunt with. Learned from them. That's the only way you can do it. Just watch other people and get all the information you can. Like I say, I'm not no professional. Don't claim to be, never will be. But just do it for fun. And what we do kill, we eat. We don't waste anything. You know, what we fish and catch, you know, if we kill it, we eat it. We catch it, we eat it. That's the way we was taught. And that's the way that my boys have been taught. And, they've, as far as what they've done, they've come out here when they was younger, they about wiped the squirrel population out. I think that's all my wife done was fix them squirrels every time they go squirrel hunting. But they've come back in like a rampage. They're about a nuisance now. But anyway, like I said, you got to live it, love it. It'll be in your blood. That's just like, you know, I'm a Christian man. I try to do the best I can, and that's just like the blood that was shed for us on the cross by Christ. You know, we try to live a Christian life and love living it, and that blood's been applied, and I appreciate that. But y'all stay tuned. I know it's a lot of rambling and jumping around, but we'll try our best to give you some better content. And right now, you probably can tell that I'm filming with a phone. I got to get some more equipment. Equipment I had a while back, it's not up to date, so I'm going to be getting some new equipment and just build this channel back up, maybe make it something, you know, for other people to learn off of. But appreciate y'all watching, and y'all stay tuned.